Okay, students, in the last class we have discussed about the parameterized query. Okay, so how to pass the parameter, that is how to pass the parameter in different way. Three methods are there to pass the argument or to pass the parameter. That is, we are in the connectivity, we are saying it's a parameterized query. Okay, there are three ways. One is by passing the variable. Normally we can store any instruction. Any instruction means any query we are storing in a into a variable, or any value that we are storing into the variable, then we are passing the variable instead of directly sending the query, directly passing the query. In execute function, we are passing the query, no? Instead of directly passing query, that query will be stored into a variable, then the variable we are using. For example, what is the plus sign, sir? I will show the example also. Here you can see execute function. Execute function, what query we passed? Can anyone say? What is the query we have passed?
Select star from EMP.
That is select all from EMP we given. Okay, that from the EMP table, we are asking to, select all the records, isn't it? So that is the query. Okay, if we are writing in this method means, for example, second time I want to use the query means it is not possible. It's not possible in the sense of I'm saying, again, I have to type the same query, isn't it? Am I right? The query is simple. Yes, sir. But anyhow, I'm saying, suppose I'm storing the query, select all, there is select star from EMP. If I store the query into a variable, I can use multiple times, no? How?
Yes, sir.
For example, I'm storing the query, select all from EMP into a variable A. Okay, A is a one variable. Okay, then whenever I need to select all the records, or whenever I need to show all the see all the records from the EMP table, okay, then I have to type simple query, that is simple command only. Program line only I have to type, code only. What is the thing? My cursor, that is cursor object dot execute of A, isn't it? So every time if I use it, just instead of typing the lengthy command, for example, this is a simple query. Suppose I'm giving a condition, where condition, class, grouping by class and having class. Likewise, I'm using many commands. Suppose I'm creating that much of lengthy query. Every time I no need to type again, that is, it is avoiding the repeating of typing. Okay, instead of if I saved that query, for example, for your case also, you can store all type of queries into a variable. Okay, then based on that variable, we can easily call it. Have you understand this one, this concept? Passing the variable.
Yes, sir.
Instead of the query. Okay, that's what we have seen. Concatenating, that is joining. Concatenating is joining. That is dynamic variable to query which values are entered. That is, here they are talking about the values. Okay. For example, in our example, name, we got one variable. Okay. And address, we got the variable ADD in the last class, I'm saying. Okay. So we are adding, we are concatenating. That is another one. And query itself, we can store as a variable. Then we can pass in the execute function as argument. There is the two ways are there in the, even in the dynamic variable. Okay. For values, to storing a values or to storing a query, we need one variable. Okay. Sorry. We are storing into a variable. Then we are passing, we are parameterizing a variable in the call statement. Okay, that is the first method we have seen. And the second method you can see using the string template. That is string template means that is we using the format specifier or access specifier. Okay, or else placeholder, another name also there. That is placeholder. Okay, so we can use multiple names. That is here we have to say it's a string template. Okay, by using the format string, that is percentage symbol. Okay, that is percentage S means it is a string, is S is denoting it's a string data type. Here placeholder is holding the place. So in this place we can pass the value, or we can pass the any variable also to. Okay, that is the concept. Okay, so that we have seen in the example. You can see I think it's not the example, I will show this later part. You will see we have seen that one. Yeah, here you can see select all from EMP where employee number equal to percentage yes. So what is the meaning? It's a placeholder, no? Or it's a access specifier, format specifier, no? So it specifies the format, that is string. Okay, so it is holding the place for what? Any one string value. What is the string value? Here you can see E we are passing. E is a tuple, that element is a single element, a tuple. So that tuple we are passing as in the form of yes, in the place of yes. So the value will be accessed. Okay, that is the second method. Okay,
sir, here I have asked a doubt, how that fetch one will be stored in the data.
Can you say what is your doubt? I forgot it. I said that at last moment. I said
just
it.
Slightly, yes, sir. Slightly scroll down, sir.
Down.
Out for the output. Yes, sir. Sir, this output will be in the tuple, sir.
Mm-hmm.
It will not be like 1 amid sale and 25,000 for the given code.
Yeah, yeah. Let me do this. Let me execute our code. Shall we do that?
Yes, sir.
Number. I forgot it, but I asked you to remember. I know that I will forget. Let me open the code and we will see. 1 minute. I will open this one. Our database is what? I mean, NCERT, no?
NCERT, sir.
That I will solve your doubt, okay. My table, our table is okay.
Yes, sir.
No online number. Okay. My table. Fine. So you are asking if I access the simple one means. Okay, there is only one. Let me write our code. We already written one code. Anyhow, we will execute it. Just a minute. Yeah, okay. Select all from EMP. That will be stored in, suppose, yeah, fetch one. We are using...
Sir,
fetch...
After that line, you give print rec.
1 minute. Yeah, this is fetch all we use it, no? So after that, we are just, you are asking to print rec. It will be print in the form of that. Yeah. 1 minute. I'm saving this. Yeah. It will be in the form of tuple. That's are you seeing, no? Hasin element. This is one element.
Sir.
Raj CBE, Rinsi CH, and there's Chennai. Yeah,
the, sir. If you know, sir, you try for fetch one function, sir. No. That also will return in the tuple only, sir. It will not be given as separate values.
Okay, that is your fetch one we are using. I'm saving again. Yeah, it will be in the tuple.
Yes, sir. Sir, there they have given output like one, no commas, then amid like that, sir.
Wait.
So, yeah,
correct, correct. What you said, I understood. Wait 1 minute. We will open this slide. What you are saying, that is okay.
According to the code, it is wrong. The output is wrong.
No. Wait, I will type this one. One more doubt. I will give the clarity. 1 minute. They are storing and afterwards they are printing the value. Okay, that is fine only. Same thing. Even though they print also the same thing printed, not fine. It will not be like that. They will be, it will be in the form of, I mean, that selected one, amid sale will be in the form of tuple. Correct.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So instead of what we can use the for loop or we can store, we can unpack the tuple. Then if you print means it will be fine, no? The output will be fine. For example, you can give one amid sales 2000, let's say 25,000, four values. Suppose A comma B comma C comma E equal to, for example, four variable equal to, then fetch one function. The fetch one will return the, for example, one record. The record will be in the form of tuple. Then we are unpacking, no? So whenever we are doing unpack, all the values will be unpacked, isn't it? So
yes, sir.
I understand, no? For example, in our case, A comma B, we have two values only, no?
Yes, sir.
A comma B, I'm just saving it. 1 minute. That will be fine. So it will be printed as a separate value. So A value is Hasan, B value is Salem. Okay, fine. Very good, Salem. There's a doubt, no? You clarified, no?
Yes, sir. Clarified.
So
sir.
I forgot it. You said it last moment because I was in the hurry to start the session for 11th. That's what I couldn't able to do that. Okay, fine. Let me go ahead with that thing. Okay. So here, let me come to the class again. I mean, remaining people also can understand that one. Can see this. Here we are using the format specifier. Instead of a variable, we are just specifying a value. That is, we are hold the place for something. Later part, later means afterwards, we are passing the variable, which it contains the value. Okay, that is the another one method by using the format specifier. And last one is pending, that by using the format function that we have seen. I will show the slide. 1 minute. Yeah, this one. String template. That is here also we are using the string template with this curly brace. Instead of percentage, it's not, we are not using the format specifier. Here we are using the this template, that curly brace temple, template, which we are using the format function. Okay, how to use this, sir? Let me see this program. It will be very easy. And another method, why we are using the variable. Some one advantages here. For specifying format specifier, runtime, definitely the user have given the input in the form of runtime, no? So we don't know which variable will store. Suppose if it is you are doing a very big project means, okay? So we can dynamically initiate any one variable. So that variable will pass. Okay, which variable it receives, that variable will pass this one. Okay, for this we are using the format specifier. I think the, can you able to hear my audio and as well as the screen, because it's showing internet
in sir, it's, is it yes okay? Sir, lightly it's
breaking.
No sir, it's not okay. It's slightly okay? Breaking.
Yeah, now how it is it okay?
Now okay sir.
Yes sir, now okay sir.
I have screen that message, that's what, internet instable likewise, that's what. Okay, let me go ahead with the new one, that is format specifier. Again we have used this the same thing we have discussed, not last. You can see the first format specifier percentage, yes. Here we are using the again placeholder, that is a format specifier. Later we are passing the d comma yes. What is d? Is one of the variable. What is yes? It's another one variable. Okay, so the d will be passed into this one, and yes will be passed in the second percentage yes. Okay, then the value will be executed sometime. That is, we are always storing all the queries into the into the variable called as query. Okay, so likewise we execute query, that we have seen, no? Initially I have said that one. Have you understand this one? Yeah.
Understood,
now
sir.
We are entering into the last topic of this this SQL, especially in the connectivity. Okay, string template with the curly brace and format function. Okay, so in this method, that is in this way of writing, we are placing the percentage yes, and we will use the, instead of percentage yes we use no, instead of we are using the curly brace, that's all. Okay, first changes is okay, they are using the format specifier, which one, the second method, the percentage yes we used. Okay, instead of the two character, here what we are using, open curly brace, close curly brace we are using. Okay, then we are passing the values in the placeholder. Placeholder means this is a placeholder. So curly braces is there, no? In between it will hold the place. Okay, by using the format function. Okay, but here what is the difference? Here we are using the function. How to use the function, sir? What is the necessity of this? Let me see this one. Okay, and next one more thing also you want to know. Inside we can give 0, 1, 2, for example. Okay, which one will be one, which one will be second, which one will be third, that is, which is first value, that is indexing, that's all. Okay, just indexing, it is not mandatory, it is not necessary also. If you give as empty means, then you can understand better. We'll go with the program, you can understand much better. Okay, you can see this is the example. You can see first thing, as you know, that I am expecting any one people, because if you explain this it will be fine, because I will come to know whether you are keeping the mind or not. Can anyone explain this program up to the fetch one function, or else input up to this e,
sir?
Yeah, yes. Yeah, Gautam, go ahead.
Sir, first we have to import MySQL dot connector, sir.
Okay.
As Ali's name, my MOS.
Okay.
Mycon is the connector object, sir.
Okay, fine.
And we have to use connect function to connect it, sir.
Super.
And we have to introduce cursor function, sir. Good. By using the variable my cursor.
Okay. So the name variable is my cursor. Sorry, cursor object.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Then we are getting on input input employee number and employee number as input from the user, sir.
Okay, that will be stored where it will be get stored
in the database, sir.
Database, sir.
Employee, no, sir, number in the variable.
What is the variable?
E, sir.
Very good Gautam, nicely said. Let me come to the next one. You can see this query equal to, that is, we are giving the same thing. So we are storing the command, we are storing the query into a variable. The variable name also, it is called as query. Okay, so we can give ABC, whatever thing. Okay, not an issue. Select all from EMP, where roll number equal to, we didn't give the roll number. Okay, instead of percentages, what we are here using? the braces, curly braces we are using. Have you understand? Where roll number equal to curly brace. That is, curly brace means it is a placeholder. It will hold the place for the value. Okay. Actually, where is the value, sir? Then you can see dot format of E. The format function will convert everything to the string data type, not in the general one. Sir, generally, shall we use the format function as a not? The format function is specifically used in the connectivity, especially it will be works in the execute function. Okay. So that's what the format function, format of E. So E is a variable, no? It will be received an integer data type that will be employee number. Okay. That the employee number will be get formatted into the string. That E will be passed. That will E, the E will be passed to the place value. That is what is the placeholder. The curly brace is there, no? So afterwards, this function will pass. Okay. The function will pass. When it will pass, sir? Generally, it will pass as, sir. Now, for example, once the query is, when we have typed, completed this line, then the whenever the query is executed, you can see my cursor dot execute query. That time only the query will be called. Have you understand? The execute function, first it want to call the query. That is, it want to pass the argument as query. Okay. Then the query, what is query? It is a variable. What's the value is contained? It contains the one query. Am I right? The select all from this one. Okay. Whenever this was encountered, encountered means are triggered or fired or whenever it's executed. Okay. Whenever it is executed, that time the place holder will wait for the value, okay, from the format function. Then only the format function will be called, okay, with the value, with the parameter, sorry, with the argument E, okay. Then this function, the format of E, will pass, return the value into the placeholder. What is the placeholder? The cursor, sorry, the curly brace. Have you understand? Okay, then
yes, sir.
This my cursor dot execute query will be executed, and rest of the things you know, na? For example, data equal to my fetch one, it will record one record from the data, I mean from the table. Then data not equal to none means it will print, because as you know, fetch one function will return none whenever there is no record. Okay, fetch many. I asked the same question also in last question, last session. Fetch many function, what will return whenever it's there is no record means. In the table,
nothing will return.
No,
none, sir.
No, fetch one
only. Empty tuple, sir.
Empty tuple. Good. See, fetch one function only return none. When it will return none, there is no record. I mean, all the records are executed. Or that's what there is no record means. It will return none. Fetch many, it will return. Empty tuple, when it will return, there is no record means. That's it. There is a difference. For example, this difference might be asked in one mark. That's all. Okay. For that purpose, I asked. Have you understand this selected one? Yes, please. Yeah.
Sir, in fetch all function, sir.
Yes.
No, sir. No, sir. Sorry, sir.
That is fetch all function, what will return if it is empty, you are asking.
It won't, no, sir. Fetch all means it will return all, no, sir.
All the things, yes. There is no nothing, no. For yes, example, sir. Nothing, no record is there means it won't return anything. It will be a zero only. It will, there is actually it will be nothing. Okay, fine. It won't return anything whenever it is false. The value is false, no. That's what it won't execute. Okay, fine. So have you all understand this one? The selected line, which I, the format of E is another one, third method or last method. So in very simple, instead of percentage, yes, we given no, that place we are giving what? The curly braces, that's all. Okay, then we have to close the double quote. Then dot, very simple, dot format, we are accessing that query. Okay, dot format of E. Format is a function. Okay, that it will pass the argument E. What is E? It is an input we got, no? So that input will be passed. For example, we are using such type of functions. Can you remember the string function? For example, if you want to change into uppercase means string dot upper function, UPPER. Can you remember?
Yes,
string,
sir.
Dot is lower, that is which string it want to convert, correct? No? So yes, that sir. Case we are using the dot operator. Likewise here. So when the function will be, I mean that time string functions, whenever we are passed the string, that time only the function will be called. Here also, whenever the query will be executed, when the query will execute, whenever it is executed by the execute function. I mean, yeah, the names are similar. That's what I am repeating like that. Have you understand this, remaining students? Yeah.
Understood, sir.
Yes, Pasalaram. Good. What about remaining? Bharat, Chandru. Chandru, today is silent. Yes, Gautam. I got it. You understood. Very good. What about Chandru? I think if you have network issue, not an issue. That is, I could understand. But what about Inivel and remaining people? Hasan, everybody, Krishna Prasad, Naveen. Have you all understand?
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Yeah,
fine. Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Good, good, good. Okay. What happened to
sir, is there any special meaning for dot in Python, sir?
This is one of the operator. It is a punctuator which we are using, no? Dot is one of the
Okay, sir.
Okay. There's okay, nothing, actually, there is no specific meaning. Whenever we are actually, we are referring something. For example, the format function will refer one string. Actually, this is a string.
Sir,
string.
Sir, pension many motto operator, sorry, sir.
I didn't get it.
Sir, fetch many.
Fencha, fetch many.
Ah, yes, sir.
Fetch many, we have to pass the argument. How many records we need to access? For example, we have to give, for example, cursor object dot whatever it may be, we are passing. Fetch many of the record, number of records you want to fetch. Fetch means how many records you want to retrieve or read from the database, sorry, from the table. Suppose three, if you mention, means three record will be, first three record will be retrieved or fetched from the mentioned table. Have you understood, Chandru?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Understood, sir.
Fine. Okay, I hope that you understand this third one. Selvaram, you ask something. Have you cleared, Ba?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good, good. Let me go to this next one. And we'll see this. Another one, example program. It will be also very much useful. Okay. Here you can see the same thing. You know that, no? The first three line. Even first, D is a input. D is a variable, receives the input department. It's a string data type. And S is a variable, receives the input in the form of integer data, that is salary, it will be received. Okay, now we come to the main point, the core part of the program. Okay, query equal to select all from EMP. See, why I am showing such program means, you want to understand that definitely we have to use where condition, everything, no. So how to pass, please listen it, okay. In your project or for even the theory exams also too, okay. Select all from EMP where department equal to, here another method. The curly braces, we didn't give as empty, but we can give a name also. That's what I will show this one to you. I have seen, you can see. For order, we can give 0, 1, 2, 3, or else what? We no need to pass, remember the order. For example, roll number name, we can give a variable name also, temporary variable name. Have you got it? Likewise, we can give, let me come to the program.
Sir, but that should be an identifier, no, sir. That should be a valid variable, no, sir.
Yeah, of course, that's what, we will see this here.
It should not be a keyword or something else.
It is, yeah, of course, it is identifier. Department is identifier, salary is identifier, no, yeah. So let you understand it. For example, where department equal to, in the cursor, single quote or double quote. Mention very carefully, I mean, listen very carefully. In the single quote or double quote, we have to mention what? Already we opened the double quotes. Definitely we should use single quote only. If you use double quotes, means what will happen? The interpreter will take, the command is over. It will be, the string is over, no? So that's why they use single quote. That is department and the salary greater than or equal to, again, salary is integer data type, no? Hello, what we received?
Yes, sir.
Department integer, will be, that is, department will be string data type. That's what
string
we mean.
Data type.
Single quote. Salary will be as integer data type. That's what we no need to mention in any quote. Okay. So that's what directly be given in the curly brace salary. Okay. What is DEPT? That is department, sir. What is salary? It is a temporary variable. It only works in this line only. Okay. That we are mentioning. No, you can see dot format of, we are passing here salary equal to S, department equal to D. What is S? What is D? You already know. What is that? That we receive the variable. That's a local variable. It's a global variable. No, we didn't define anything.
Yes, sir.
So it's a normal or global variable, which we are received the department into the variable D, and salary, which we received in the variable S. Okay. So we are, what is the thing? We are transferring the value, or we are reassigning the value. So S value will be now assigned to where? Salary. D value will be assigned to department. What type of argument this is? Can anyone say?
Named argument.
Very good. Named argument or what is the thing? Keyword argument. Correct, no?
Yes.
So that is the argument. Now you can see, first we need department, next we need salary. But even though we given what? First salary we received, department, not an issue. As you know, no? Named argument or keyword argument, we can pass in whatever order. But what is the important? The name is important. Here, suppose you can see, I'm highlighting. Here we use DEPT, no? Suppose here if you use DEPT, there also we should use what? The call statement also we should
DEPT
use
only.
Same thing, yeah, same variable only. Here salary means here, there also salary. That we have seen in the named argument concept, the third chapter, isn't it? So there you know that the format function will formatize, that is it will format, salary will be what format. Here we mention as integer, that will be passed. Okay, then department also passed. That is, the S value will be assigned to salary, D value will be assigned to department. Then again, whenever that we call the format function means, what will happen? The salary will be stored in this place, in the placeholder, okay? With the name that we given as a name, okay? Then department will be stored in the this place, okay? Then it will execute query. Suppose I'm entering department equal to HR, suppose as you're seeing the example, no? And the salary equal to 50,000. What is the query? Will execute select all from EMP, where department equal to HR, okay, and salary equal to 50,000. That's all. That is the thing. Simple thing. Okay,
sir. So greater than
50,000. Okay, pa. I said less than. Okay, so sorry for that. I didn't understand that. I didn't mean it. Okay, that is whatever query we are giving, greater than or less than. That's what I said. Greater than only, I think so. Okay, not an issue. Let me see. So we are executing the query. That query will be, the entire query will be where it is stored. It means you can say this, that line alone. Okay, where it will be stored means it will be stored in the variable query. Okay, we can give whatever variable also, not an issue. Okay, that is, we are executing now the query. Really, this line only we are actually doing the execution. All the things will be executed through the one function that is called what? Execute function. So the execute function will call the, we pass the, we are calling the function with the argument query. What is query? It is a variable. It contains another one. That variable having another one calling the function implicitly, automatically calls the function format with the two arguments. Likewise, in this example, they are giving two arguments. We can pass number of arguments. That's what. That is a use, or there is a facility, okay, for using the format function. We can pass number of. We no need to mention that. For example, first one is salary, second one is department. We no need to maintain any order. Okay, we can give whatever order automatically because it is a named argument. No, so that's what the name will be, will receive the proper value. It will always refer the name, other is keyword. Okay, have you understood? Keyword means I'm saying the argument sense, keyword argument, named argument. Have you understand what is the use of the format function? It's the uniqueness of this one.
Understood, sir.
Yeah. Now you can see data equal to, that is fetch all. We are recording. I mean, we are getting all the data. I mean, all the records from the table. EMP, no? Yeah, EMP. That will be stored in the variable data. That is n record equal to row count function. As you know that it will just tell how many rows are executed. For example, we use the fetch all function, no? So all the records. Suppose the table contain 5 records means the row count will be returned 5. That 5 will be stored in the variable nrec. Nrec is just a variable. Okay, that's all. We are printing the variable, and where nrec not equal to 0, whenever the nrec is not equal to 0, what will happen? The for loop will execute. It will print one by one. Okay, so first thing, it will print what? For example, you can see the example also. Okay, they are asking the HR department, enter the department, enter salary. They are asking total record 2. Because 2 records are there in the HR department, suppose the table may contain. Okay, then it will print
the left side downstairs. They have given the table also, sir.
Yeah, yeah. I think, yeah, 2. Vikas and Nitin only is HR.
Yes, sir.
It is gone. Okay, fine. So, likewise, it's printing that 2 records only. Suppose they are giving HR, those who are get 55,000, that is greater than, that's what enter salary means, greater than or equal to 55,000 means. From 55,000, it will show. So whose record that is? Nitin only got 56,000. No, that's what.
Yes, sir.
That likewise we can do a search also. That is the method. Remaining students, have you all understand format function method?
Yes, sir.
In the parameterized query. three methods.
Yes, sir. Understood.
Yes, sir.
Three methods. Yes, sir. The last method or the third method. Good. Let me see one more example. That's what. Now we are. We already discussed this one. Anyhow, I will teach again. Inserting data. We already discussed that program. How to write the data.
Yes, sir.
That is how to insert the record or update. Update we didn't see. Insert only we have seen one program. That is how insert the record means by using the query. Let me see this. By afterwards we are seeing the commit function also. I have thought. I will show for your understanding. Then we will go ahead. I think this program only we have done. Of course. Can you see this is the insert method. That's we are inserting the table. The query will be we are storing into one variable. And the values, okay, instead of percentage here in the third method, if I want to use means what I have to give values, the curly brace, comma, curly brace, or else we can give the values also. That is any one named argument we can pass. Have you understand this? Instead of second
yes,
method,
sir. Yes, sir.
You can use the third one also. So what is percentages and percentages means we are giving the val. Val contains the name and there is add. That is another one variable. So one more minute is there. Just rejoin it. Afterwards, we will start this next one. Update function. Once we completed, that means we will successfully completed the second unit also. Okay, there is SQL also. So okay, thereafter, sir. There is no obstacle okay, for sir. Completion of your project also. Okay. Next yes, week, probably I will start the review. I will doing the process. I started. I'm waiting for the another JE students also. They also for them continue together. I will give it. So for that only. Once I completed for them, next week will be your review. So side by side, you start to prepare for that. Okay. I mean, you can do the your project work also. Anyway. I hope you are all doing, isn't it? Are you all doing no your project? Hello. Am I audible? Okay, so in this program we are passing the value that is in the variable val, then we are executing the query SQL comma val. Okay, it is another method. Okay, so we have done the table, that is we created the table my table and we stored this three records, no? So in the same format we are creating it. Okay, fine. Whenever we are creating, now if I execute this means you can see it will I think it will show error. Let me see it. See, because what is the error? Can you say? It's clearly showing. What is the error? What is the
one
error?
Second to the program.
Program no error, man. I mean, I'm saying there is no problem in the program. But why the error is happened? Can you know? You can see, read the error. That's what I keep testing. What is the error? My table. Already exist.
Correct,
no? We already created the my table, no? That's from that only we are stored the house in Salem and like that we store the data, no? So once again we are asking to create the table with the same name means it is not possible, no? So that's what I'm saying. Okay. So that is the thing. This may be why I'm showing this, pointedly showing this error means you have to learn. So suppose you may think that SQL is not connected. It is not. Whenever the table is existed, you know, generally, no. For example, if I manually, if you want to create the same table, again, means it is not possible. Table name already there. Okay, it won't allow even in the SQL. So that's it. Suppose instead of that, my table one, if I use means, it is okay. Have you understand? Suppose you can see my table one, yes, I am using. So it will execute, I think so. Of course. We'll wait for one more minute, I think. Yeah, now. See, now it is asking how many records you want to enter. Suppose I am giving two. Now you can see enter the name. I am just giving Anand. Okay. The address. Okay. Just give anything. Okay. I'm just giving a second record. Can you say anything? Ziha. It's giving
Canada, sir.
Canada.
Yes, sir.
So likewise, we inserted. Let me see the check into the SQL. 1 minute. So we use the NCERT, no? 1 minute.
We use NCERT.
We use nctrt. Okay.
Select all from my table.
Select all from my table one. Isn't it?
Oh, yes, sir. New table.
Table one. Oh. What is the error? First, you check that.
Okay, sir.
Okay. 1 minute now. Show tables. My table one is there. Let me check. 1 minute. We will go ahead with the program. I mean, okay, the password, database, everything okay. First, we will do the delete one. Suppose I'm just creating my table two. Okay, so let me check.
Sir, yes.
Okay. Yes.
Really sorry, Chandra.
Insert into my table one.
See, wow, really, Chandru, superb, nice.
Sir?
He got the.
Very nice.
Superb. Can anyone say this error? Why it is not? It's showing empty. Chandru got the point. Very good. No, here we change that, but here in the insert command. Did we change the table name? Again, we are trying to...
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Super. Nice, Chandru. Super. Nicely said. For example...
Thank you, sir.
Create, yeah. So, table 2. My table 2. Here we are doing. Now, if you run this means, it will be fine. I think first... again, 2. I'm just giving... giving Watson. So, I'm just giving again... URL. Okay, so now we can check that my table two, the table name is okay. Let me go ahead.
Yes,
very nice, Chandru. Really, I appreciate you. I think we opened twice. 1 minute. Let me check. Okay. Oh. Now it is showing, no? It's properly stored.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's what. See, there is a very minute mistake we made, done. So you can see that I will show the code first. First, I will close this one. I don't know which one. It is not ours. See, this is the thing. Same thing. We already dealt with this example. So this is the normal method we have. Give this. How to give that? Store the record. Insert the record into the table that we have seen. That is the example program we have seen. 1 minute, I will show this one. Okay, this is what we have seen. Insert. Okay, now we are going to see the update. How to do the updation? Insert. Can anyone explain this program? This insert method only. It's another one format. Another by using the format third method. Okay, can anyone explain this program? Hello. No one.
Sir, may I?
Yeah, please, Selvaram. Go ahead.
Sir, first we are importing MySQL connector as MYS alias name. Okay. And mycon is a connector object, and using connect function, we are connecting the database into the Python function, sorry, okay. Python program.
Okay.
And we are creating cursor using cursor object mycursor.
Okay.
Then we are printing welcome to data entry.
Welcome.
Then we are assigning string y, small y into answer. So we are using while loop.
Super. Because we are using while loop for that, we need one variable for given as a condition.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Sir, and the answer is equal to y, edukka, sir.
He will tell that. Selvaram, can you explain it?
Yes, sir. We have to while we are using a while loop, we have to give the condition for execution of it.
Actually, so, this is syntax. No, Chandru. Sir. Chandru.
Yes, sir.
That is, as Selvaram said, no, it is a syntax. Because first we need variable, there is variable initialization, then while condition, then body of the loop, then increment or decrement, that is updation. That is the syntax of while loop. Yes, Selvaram, you can explain to him.
I mean, yes, then we are getting employee number in ENO variable. Then we are getting the name of the employee in NM variable.
Okay.
Then department in DP variable. Then salary, we are getting an S. Then we are assigning a variable query, and we are in we are giving query as a string, insert into employee value.
So the EMP,
we are using the third method of
in between. Your voice is break, Rupa. Can you explain it again?
Okay, sir. We are giving insert into employee values, and
employee
we are
is
giving
a table name, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Good. Values of
Then using the third method, we are giving the inputs for 0, 1, 2, and 3.
Good.
Yes, sir. Using format function, we are inserting the values into the query.
Okay.
And then we are using the my cursor object, and we are executing that query.
Dot format of, yes, this one only. Dot format of ENO, that is employee number, name, DP, department, and salary, yes. Okay. Three variables that we are passing. So definitely the ENO will be goes to the zeroth index. That is the first index, no? So it will be to the zeros one, and that will be NM will be goes to the first number one, where the number one is mentioned, and DP will be number two, and yes, that is salary will be number three. So it is in ordered as a indexed one. Okay. Last example program we have seen, we have used the named argument or default. What's that? Keyword argument, named argument, we have seen in the last program, the same format function, no? So salary and department, in whatever order we pass, it will settle. But here we are ordering 1, 2, 3. Whether it is necessary, sir, if you're asking, not. We can avoid it. We can give what? Just empty curly braces. Empty curly brace, comma, again, empty curly brace. Likewise, also, if we give, automatically it will store. The zero first will be stored in the first empty curly brace. Second element means here NM, I'm saying. Okay, that element will be stored in the second empty space. Likewise, yes, Selvaram, go ahead.
Then we are using commit function to run the queries and execute
commit
all those things.
Commit function will make sure that data will be properly stored in the executed or not properly stored in the database. Yes, next one.
Then we are printing record saved. And we are asking, we have to add more or not, and we are getting it in the answer variable. If any other than the Y, then the loop will stop running.
Yeah, we are suppose we given any one input, that input will be again here in the while loop, it will check. The entered input is equal to Y means, then the set of codes will be again, it will execute. Isn't it? Suppose
yes,
if I, rather than Y, if I give any variable N or, any value, if I pass it means, then it will not execute. I mean, this while loop will not execute again. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is the main concept why we are using the while loop here. Okay. So very good. Nicely explained, Selvaram. What about remaining students? Have you all understand what Selvaram explained?
Yes, sir.
Superb. Nice.
Yes, sir.
Yes, good. So I hope it is an another method to that. Okay, just adding, that is inserting the record into the existing table. That's all. Okay, that is the thing. Here we didn't create the table. I will show the program. In this program, suppose I want to insert the same record, sir, then I can avoid this one. You can see this, my cursor is there, no? This line, if I made as a comment line means, what is the thing? It will be stored into the existing table. Okay, because we are giving the command first thing, create table. So if I no need to create any table, I will remove this line. That's all. If I remove, then you'll execute means all the record will be stored in the mentioned table. Here table 2 means table 2, it will be stored. Okay. Have you all understand this one? Program.
Yes, sir.
This one and this one. Very good. Let me go to the last one. Updating.
Yes,
record.
Sir.
Yeah. Updating record. How to do the updation? Okay. So as we discussed, as we seen in the last program, we are getting all the values. Welcome to employee data, update screen. There is just a print message. And employee number, we are receiving the variable ENO. Okay. Then we are executing the query. What is the query? Okay. Select all from EMP where employee number equal to the specific employee number. What is the employee number? Suppose I entered 5. that data will be stored. Okay, then my cursor dot execute of, we are executing the query, then fetch one will function, because what is stored in the what the query will do, I mean this my execute function, what it will do, it only select where the employee number is equal to that particular number, isn't it?
Yes.
For example, if I mention employee number is one, means suppose the table may contain only one record which employee, whose employee number is one, suppose, if it is, means then automatically only one data, I mean one record will be there. So fetch one function automatically will record, it will fetch the record, okay, that will be stored in the variable data. Okay, now you can see, if data not equal to zero, suppose employee number, total employee number itself 100, okay, suppose I am entering 101, that is 101 I entered, employee number is not there, that time what will happen, it will return none. No, so that's what, the data is none, record that is record found details are, I mean not equal to none means, okay, suppose if it is none means, you can see, sorry, no such employee exists, likewise it will mention the message, it will display the message, okay, not equal to none, then record found details are, then it will print all the details, that is the fetched details. Okay, are you sure to update the salary? Here the program is, core concept is how to update the salary. Okay, they are asking the yes or no question. If the answer is yes means, then the if condition will be executed. What is the thing? Yes equal to, again new salary it will get, then query equal to update, you can see this, no, we have executed that one, update table,
yes sir. Set, table, yeah, set
update
salary is equal to that amount.
Yes, very
and employee number, we are given conditions, where is employee number is equal to,
so update table, that is update table name, set field name, okay, that is here update EMP, we are updating the EMP table, where what is the updation we are making, that is what we are doing, the updation, set salary equal to a specific salary, we are updating the salary, where, in which based on which condition, whether for all or a particular one, suppose if you are particular means, we have to give the condition, no, that's what, where employee number equal to another one placeholder we are giving, okay, then format function we are passing the two place, that is S is a new salary, no, that will be S is we received, and ENO is what we already received, it it's a global variable, am I right? So that ENO is a variable that we get the employee number. So in this specified employee number, we are updating the salary. Then that will be executed. Once it is executed, it's not. We need to use the commit function. Then only the record will be permanently stored in the database. If you forgot to give commit function, means it will not execute. Okay. So we have to use the commit function also. Then I just print a record updated. Likewise, it will print. Okay. Have you understand? Here they are,
it's a commit function or close function, Maria, sir.
So but not exactly close. Of course, I said the same thing. Here, likewise, they want to say, there they are using mycon.close function also they are using in order to close the file. It is optional, but.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
But it is
okay, optional.
Sir. Okay, fine. Have you understand how to execute this update function?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, sir, one more doubts in the fetch one function, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, now we are getting only one employee number, so that we are using fetch one function, sir, and it will return only one record, sir. So what if we not give two or three records are there, and if we give fetch one function, only one record will return, no sir, we cannot use that in this story.
In this case we cannot use the fetch one function, but what is the thing, we can do it. How to check means, let I will tell, for example, instead of updating the can you say anyone case means, I will explain. For example, mobile number, okay, for example you and me, we are going for, and for example we are registering, okay, instead of for example two persons entering the same mobile number, correct, they want to one of the member given wrongly, okay, so this is not my mobile number, it is another mobile number, but I want to update mobile number. In this case, instead of update salary, we are update mobile number. For example, employee number are based on employee mobile number, where mobile number equal to, we are giving the mobile number, no? So two mobile number, yes, will be here. Duplicate values also it will display. Okay.
Yes, then what is the thing?
Yeah, correct. In this case, how to use the fetch one means, we are getting the query, no, that will be stored in, instead of fetch one, we have to give fetch all function. Okay. So fetch all function will, or else we can do that. For example, fetch all function that will receive the data, everything will be in one variable. Okay, then we need to segregate with that, or else we can segregate with the list, append the list. For example, we can store into a list. Okay, then list value, we are selecting the value. For example, list of suppose name, what is the thing here? Let me see this table. Employee name, employee number, name, department, salary. For example, instead of salary, there is mobile number, if it is means. Okay, that is, what is the value? List of three, isn't it? Where list of three equal to the particular mobile number? Or for example,
yes,
Ramesh, okay, one mobile number, Suresh, another mobile number. But what is the thing? Ramesh and Suresh, they given the same number. Actually, that is a real number of Ramesh. But Suresh also, what is the thing? They given Ramesh number. Later, well, he wants to update. Yeah. So we have, yes, to update only the Suresh number. No. For example, in this case, we need to get the name also. Okay. Then what is the thing?
Yes,
the list of 01. No. 1 is a name. Okay. In this case of list, I am saying. So list of 1 equal to Suresh. If it is means, then we have to do the same updation process. Have you understand, pa?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
I think. So we have to write extra code for that. Very simple. Just we are, instead of variable, we are using a list. Then we are checking one more loop we have to use, definitely. Because two or three records may be there, no duplicate value. So instead of that, we have to use the for loop. Then we have to check the name. If the name is matched, means that record only we have to update it. Have you understand?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, good.
Understood, sir.
That is simple method. Or else, as you see, no, where employee number, instead of employee number, only one right, only one line itself we can complete. Where employee name equal to Suresh.
Oh, okay,
have you understand? No? It is another one. For example, Suresh, yes, is telling, sir, actually my database, it is showing wrong number, sir. Mobile number is wrong, sir. I need to update my mobile number, sir. Very simple. Instead of employee number, or else employee number, and also we can use and employee number equal, employee name equal to Suresh. We can give additional condition, no? So in this case, we can write it in the one line itself. Have you understood?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, fine. What about remaining students? Have you all understand this update function?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Very good. I hope that all will understand. Please review the video, this video, okay, class video, in order to get the familiarity. Moreover, if you have any doubt, means please ask, don't hesitate. I'm often saying this dialogue. Okay, just we successfully completed that SQL also. Tomorrow onwards, we will step into the third chapter. Third unit, that is as per your book, it is the second unit, networks. Okay, so that will be very easy as well as very interesting also. Okay, once we completed, it will be very lengthy one. That's not easy that much quickly to have to complete. It will take some time to complete it, but we are entering into the last step in the portion completion. Okay, we successfully completed the project related or practical related things. Okay, hereafter there is no I have to do from my part, that is, except that the 30 list of practicals alone I have to give. Okay, just list of programs. You have to write the program, you have to buy hard, or you have to understand, that is in your case. But practical and project related, we completed all the theories. Only is one theory completed is there, the completion is there, that is network. Okay. Thank you, students, for your cooperation. Again, I'm expecting you, your full attendance. Okay, then you can understand. Fine. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you, sir.